طيب، بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. Any questions before we proceed? Any questions before we proceed? Some of you were asking me regarding the quiz next Tuesday. I was hesitant. يعني should I include 5.3 ولا I should not؟ يعني when based on your performance في the strong induction question في الكويز الماضي. Well, I should have a whole quiz على الاندكشن مرة تانية. بس to make it easier since it's Ramadan, يعني خلاص we'll just make it 6.1, 6.2, 6.3. Okay. اللي هي section 1 وsection 2 وsection 3. Section 4 هذا اللي راح ناخده الآن ما هو داخل في الكويز. Okay. إيه اللي خلصنا يوم الثلاثاء. Okay. طيب. Okay, so let's move on. This is an interesting section. We will see the binomial theorem, which seems to be, يعني, not that interesting, but you will see that some results can be, you know, amazingly, you know, proved using the binomial theorem. Okay, so what is the binomial theorem? Well, let x and y be variables, and let n be a non-negative integer. Then x plus y to the power n is equal to the summation from j equals 0 to n, n choose j, x to the power n minus j, y to the power j, y to the power j. And I remember when I took the binomial theorem, the version that I took was that x plus y to the power n is equal to summation n choose j from j equals 0 to n, x to the power j, y to the power n minus j. Now, my question to you is, are they exactly the same? They're exactly the same, huh? ليش؟ ترى ال n choose j مش هي نفسها ال n choose n minus j؟ This is one way of looking at it. Another way of looking at it. مش هذه x plus y to the power n؟ مش هي نفسها y plus x to the power n؟ If you switch them, you will get the second one. Okay? If you switch them, you will get the second. So whichever you use, if you use it correctly, you will get the right answer. Okay? You will get the right answer. So let's look at some applications of the binomial theorem. We will start with a kind of a very direct application of the binomial theorem. What is the expansion of x plus y all to the power 3? Okay, so if I want to use the binomial theorem, what should I say? X plus y to the power 3, x plus y to the power 3 is equal to summation from j equals 0 to 3, aywa, 3 choose j, x to the power 3 minus j, y to the power j. X to the power 3 minus j, y to the power j. طيب ايش بيساوي هذا؟ Let's expand the summation. So what is the first term in the summation? 3 choose 0, صح? X to the power 3, y to the power 0, plus second term, 3 choose 1, x square, y to the power 1, plus 3 choose 2, x to the power 1, y square, plus L3 choose 3, x to the power 0, y cube. X to the power 0, y cube. So what is this equal to? H to 3 choose 0, 1. So this is basically x cube. Will y to the power 0? Will y to the power 0, 1. So this is basically x cube plus h to 3 choose 1, 3 x squared y plus the 3 choose 2. نفسه 3 choose 1 هو نفسه 3 choose 2 صح؟ So plus 3 x y square plus the 3 choose 3 هو نفسه 3 choose 0 when x to the power 0 is 1 وهذاك 1 so this is y cube. Okay شباب any question? So it's a very straightforward application of the binomial theorem. طيب let's look at now the second question. Now, in the second question, it says the following. It says, what is the coefficient of x to the power 12 times y to the power 13 in the expansion of 2x minus 3y all to the power 25? How do you think we should solve this question? Apply the binomial theorem, صح? طيب, how do you want to apply the binomial theorem? إيش نكتب؟ ها؟ So basically, let's write it down. Let's write it down from the beginning, صح? So what do I have? Basically, I have 2x minus 3y to the power 25. What is this equal to? Summation from j equals 0 up to 25. Aywa. 25 choose j. طيب. 2x to the power 25 minus j. صح? Multiplied by minus 3y, ما تنسوا الماينس, minus 3y to the power j, minus 3y to the power j. طيب, so let me put it this way. So since 2x minus 3y all 25 is sigma from j equals 0 to 25, 25 choose j, 2x all to the power 25 minus j multiplied by minus 3y all to the power j. Where is the coefficient of x to the 12, y to the 13? J equal 13, صح? When j is equal to 13. And why did we choose j equal to 13? Well, it's very obvious because we need y to the power h. We need y to the power 13. Y here is to the power j. So we will get it when j is equal to 30. Okay, so this is what I'm gonna write. So since this is equal to this, the coefficient of x to the 12, y to the 13 occurs in term j equal 13 of the expansion, صح? Of the summation, right? Of the summation. Okay. Yalla ya shabab, hatu lanshuf. When j is equal to 13, so what is what is that term when j is equal to 13? أول شيء 25 choose 13, صح? So when j equal 13, we have 25 choose 13 multiplied by 2x to the power 12 minus 3y to the power 13 minus 3y to the power 13. Hence, the coefficient is what? The coefficient is basically قبلت to the power 12 ما تنسو ل 25 choose 13. Do not forget ل 25 choose 13. 2 to the power 12 minus 3 to the power 13. Minus 3 to the power 13. And by the way, this is equal to هلا بالنسبة لل minus 3 to the power 13 راح تكون negative ولا positive؟ Negative because it is odd, صح؟ So this is minus. بعدين ل 25 you choose 13 is what? Is basically 25 factorial, صح؟ Over 13 factorial times 12 factorial. هاي ل 25 choose 13 multiplied by 2 to the power 12 multiplied by 3 to the power 13. So this is the coefficient of x to the power 12, y to the power. If we choose j equal 12, if you choose j equal 12, you might get the same answer, but it's not the coefficient of x to the 12, y to the 13. It's the coefficient of x to the 13, y to the 12. بس لأنهم جنب بعض, they might be equal, or they are equal, صح? So the final answer is correct, but the way you got it is not correct, right? نعم. Where did the summation go? It's a single term. إحنا بدنا بس the coefficient لل x to the 12, y to the 13. The summation terms. بس لما الجي بتساوي 13 في ترم تاني في x to the power 12 y to the power 13 اعطيني واحد اي x to the power 12 y to the power في اشي تاني غير الجي equal 13 بيعطيك x to the power 12 y to the power 13 خلاص فانت you just need one term okay you just need one term نعم three choose zero is one. Yes, n choose zero is one. عيد مرة تانية. Which formula? I. Huh? Zero factorial is yeah zero factorial is one, but you want to apply the formula هذه hey فعندك انت three factorial divided by three factorial times zero factorial with zero factorial by definition is equal to one it's equal to one طيب now this is elegance in its, you know, best form, okay? This is beauty. What is the summation of n choose k from k equals 0 to n? Hint, use the binomial theorem. طيب ايش بدك الاكس تساوي what do you want x
يعني
Yes, yes. You want x plus y to the power n. صح؟ طيب. How can you use هال x plus y to the power n to show that sigma n choose k from k equals 0 to n to find sigma n choose k from k equals 0 to n. Huh? X, y equals 0? Two to the power n? كيف two to the power n? X, y equal 1. حط x equal 1, y equal 1. هلا, if we do 1 plus 1 to the power n, if I use the binomial theorem, what does the binomial theorem say? Sigma. Actually, let's go here directly. So, since 1 plus 1 to the power n, which is equal to the summation from k equals 0 to n, n choose k, aywa, 1 to the power n minus k multiplied by 1 to the power k. El 1 to the power k, ايش بيساوي? 1. Well, 1 to the power n minus k, ايش بيساوي? 1. For any n, for any k, صح? So basically, this is the same as sigma n choose k that I want from k equals 0 to n. What is this equal to? ايش هذا? ال 1 plus 1. شايفين هالحلاوة? 2 to the power n. A very nice proof. Very nice proof for the fact that summation n choose k for k equals 0 to n is actually equal to 2 to the power n. Using the binomial theorem. طيب اللي وراها. Yes. الx تساوي 1 والy minus 2. ليش انت شايف قدامك هون minus 2 to the power k او minus 2 to the power n minus k? Minus 1 plus 0 ولا minus 1 plus 1? The final answer is 0. طيب, so let's... this is like the previous one, but with a twist. Okay? So, again, I'm going to say, since 1 plus minus 1 to the power n, هذا إيش بيساوي? By the binomial theorem, summation n choose k from k equals 0 to n, 1 to the power n minus k multiplied by minus 1 to the power k. Okay? Minus 1 to the power k. هذا ايش بيساوي? ال 1 minus 1 to the power n. 1 minus 1 كم بيساوي? 0. 0 to the power n. This is equal to 0. صح? This is equal to 0. So therefore, the summation, this summation is equal to 0, right? No. No? Why not? Aywa. K is starting from 1. طيب, what should I do?
We start from 1. And...
Yeah. This summation, let me take out the first term, right? And then it will be plus the summation above. صح? So this is equal to what? Well, when k is equal to 0, what do we have? We have n choose 0, صح? 1 to the power n minus 1 to the power 0, صح? This is the first term. طيب, plus, now I can write the summation of l minus 1 to the power k, n choose k, k from 1 to n, which is... Now, this is exactly the same summation. So, this plus this is equal to ايش? Is equal to 0, صح? This plus this is equal to 0. So, now, if I want this summation, what should I do? I should compute this and take it to the other side, صح? What is this equal to? 1. So, therefore, so... which is equal to, so let me call this S, okay, summation S. So this is equal to 1 plus S, صح? Therefore, the summation S, إيش رح يساوي? Summation S رح يساوي minus 1. شو رأيكم يا شباب? Very nice, صح? Very nice. و questions and quizzes, exams, وهذا كله رح يكون من هالنمونة يعني. That's why I'll get you really trained في الactivity. الactivity راح تكون full of it. Okay. طيب. So let's cover the last topic before I give you the activity. Let's cover the full topic before I give you the activity. So let n and k be positive integers with n greater than or equal to k. Then we have n plus 1 choose k is equal to n choose k minus 1 plus n choose k. N plus 1 choose k is n choose k minus 1 plus n choose k. Note here that, you know, we are getting the value of n plus 1 choose k from two previous values. اللي هي n choose k minus 1 plus n choose k. Now, if you look at this, first of all, let's look at these values. For example, 0, 0. Can I apply Pascal's identity on this? No, because k is 0. هنا لازم تكون الk إيش؟ Positive, صح؟ طيب, 1, 0 نفس الشيء. الk is 0. طيب, وهذا ال 1, 1. Can I apply it? أنا بقول no. ليش؟ أيوة ال n لازم يكون 2 and above. Notice here, it says n is positive. وعندي هنا إيش؟ n plus 1. If n is positive and n plus 1, then the value here, ال n plus 1, at least should be equal to 2. So this does not apply on this row also. However, it applies later on. Now, this is very interesting to note. First of all, do you notice that this is kind of a triangle, صح? And what are the values at the end points? 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 2, 0, 5. كلهم هدول إيش? They are all ones, صح? The ones here, اللي هم 1 choose 1, 2 choose 2, 3 choose 3, they are all إيش? They are all also ones. So this formula or this identity can make me fill these values from the previous values. So for example, 2 choose 1. What is the value of 2 choose 1 according to the identity? It is 1 choose 0 plus 1 choose 1. Hey, 1 choose 0 plus 1 choose 1. Okay? And basically, you put the terms in this triangle, which is basically called Pascal's triangle, which is basically called Pascal's triangle. So if you do it this way, you can basically get the value of each row from the row before it. صح ولا لا? We can get the value of each row from the row before it. For example, let's say the value here in the next row, when n is equal to 9. By the way, this which number does it, which combination does it correspond to? Well, it is 8 choose 5 plus 8 choose 6. But this is equal to what? 9 choose 6. Huh? This is equal to 9 choose 6. So you can get 9 choose 6 from 8 choose 5 plus 8 choose 6. So you can actually build that triangle on your own. Okay? You just need to add the above two terms, right? The above two terms, and you will get that. You will get that. So this is the nice thing about Pascal's identity. Okay? واضح يا شباب? So let's move on to the activity now. You're ready? يلا. تيجوا ثلاثة هنا طالما انت اثنين ولا بدل ما نفرقكم عن بعض. طيب تحبوا انتوا الاثنين؟ في حاجز بينكم وبين طيب would you like to come here انتوا تكونوا ثلاثة اثنين طيب انتوا اثنين I'll give you 11 minutes for this one. ايش رايكم؟ I want to give you enough time. وباي نعم. Which one? This one? This one? الان اكبر من او يساوي كي. ليش؟ لأنه I'm trying to find the n plus 1 choose k. صح؟ Okay شباب right now I'm saving them I'm saving the slides so that you can upload them on your mobiles okay Okay. Yeah, you can upload them on your mobiles.
I think one. لازم اكتبها دي بقى لازم اكتبها
لازم اكتبها
صح 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 ص
خلصتوا؟
في ترك
نعم. إذا فهمت اثنين آخر سؤالين حليناهم أو آخر ثلاث أسئلة.
حس اليوم
مسهل. It's exactly it's exactly the same.
بس اليوم حس.
يلا يا شباب مين مين يجي يحللنا أول واحد هنا؟
أنا حليت أنت شو
تحل؟ لا بدك تحلها على ال. الورقة والقلم كله هنا. ترى حط ايدك على الايباد عادي اذا كانك حاطط ايدك على ورقة.
ايه
ما راح يعني. يلا اسمعوا يا شباب.
اول شيء نكتب الترم بعدين.
اوكي سو فيرست هي وود لايك تو رايت ذا اكسبانشن اوف 3x minus 4y to the power 17. صح؟
أنا بكتب الترم بس ال.
أنت بدك تكتب الترم. طب شو رأيك أول شيء تكتب السميشن؟
أوكي طيب.
نغلبك شوي.
كيف أنت؟
just do this. يلا go ahead.
It's summation of.
So 3x minus 4y to the power 17 is the summation from j equals 0 to
17.
Aywa.
Of معلش دكتور انا قاعد اضيع شوي 17 to
17 choose j
17 choose j 3x
to the power
j
عادي كمل 3x to the power j minus 4y to the power
n minus j or 17 minus j
شطب على n وقت 17 okay. 17 minus j ونسيت
الواي
صح
minus 4y ايه ما انا ضايع دكتور معلش
اوكي
بعدين نكتب الترم الحين خلاص
now you can write the term go ahead
okay so the term is when 17
so the term is for j equal ish
for j when j is equal to 10
when j is equal to 10 شايفين يا شباب هنا when j is equal to 10 so it will be 17 choose 10 ايوه
3x 17 minus 4y Is this right?
No. هذه 17 هذه 10 صح؟
ايه 10 اوكي انا حسيت في شيء غلط.
Yeah. This is equal to
okay.
Okay. 10 is 7 10 فكتوريال